Hello, everybody, and welcome to Keeping It Spiritually Simple. It is my great honor today to have Awakening Tribes, well, Michelle's better half, Samuel, is here today. Michelle had to work, but she'll join us next time. And Samuel and I are having a pre-conversation about all the energies right now and the shifting and the feeling of it being so different and not being able to put our finger on what the real reason is. And if a lot of these things are happening, is it being done because it's forcing us out of our box? And, you know, Samuel, the interesting thing is I had this conversation with someone the other day that people get very comfortable in their box. And unless they get out of it, they don't understand the expansion, you know, of the world because they're living in this little comfort zone. I think some people take a pencil and poke a hole in the box and maybe look out a little bit, but that's a whole new world out there. I'm staying right here. I want my dinner at 5 and my bath at 8 and nighttime at my bedtime at 5:30 or 8:30 or whatever it is. Yeah, breakfast at 6 and lunch at 12. And it's like, and from my perspective, when I talk like that, I see my great grandparents, you know, everything needed to be more regimented. And then now my parents are up there at that age and I see them more regimented. And I've said to both my girls, if I ever start talking like that, please feel free to slap me upside my head and say, "You're acting old, Mom." And I'll be like, "Oh yeah, forgot. Didn't want to act like that. Never mind. Bring me dinner an hour later."
Yes. No, it's I mean, the discussion that we had was, again, it's interesting because you have so much things going on right now that showing the ancient perception and way of living that our grandparents, our grand-grandparents had, that I do believe that all those generation from 40 until 50, I do believe that we are here for making the transition between the ancient generation and the new generation. Mm-hmm. Because when we look at the new generation, they are very, very individualist. They are not living in the same capacity of family perception, respect, exchange. We teach them so much at school to relieve challenge, to be competitive, that they don't pay attention about themselves first, because when we raise ourselves, our conscious, then we raise the conscious around us. And it's something that people don't get. I had a lot of, you know, as you probably do on Facebook or other social media, when we discuss with people, even some people tell you, "Oh, I'm awakened," and you're like, "Okay, I'm not." And when people are like, "What?" And I said, "No, we are into the process of being awakened, but we are not awake. Because if we were awake, we will have all our power, all our capacity, your skills." And we don't. We're still searching how to deal with. And so it's, to me, it's what I was telling you just before. We are, once again, into the transition of getting out of our box. We still have our habits, the society habits that the program that we accepted to have, and we start to deprogram all these things, but we still be into the individualism and not thinking about the family, the roots, the community. And this is an interesting thing, because it's asking us to look and perceive things completely differently than our grandparents, or even my mom. I was discussing with her this morning, and she was telling me, "No, but I do believe that some things change, the time completely change, it's faster." And I'm like, "Yeah, but you are not going older faster, it's just the perception." She was like, "Oh my God, that's terrible." So it's still be, you know, it's the person inside the house, and it's still raining outside and people are scared to be wet. And you are like, "But get out. Try to be outside, try to take the rain, and you will see how your body will regenerate, how your body will react, how people around, the silence or the noise that the rain will. So for me, it's a perfect time to work on ourselves and raise the consciousness of ourselves and all the people around us.
Yes, and the first step is raising it within yourself. And really, awakeness just means that you're becoming more aware of information and different pathways of information than what you were originally taught. If I think back to when I was a kid, if you wanted information to write a book report, if your parents had enough money, you had an encyclopedia, set up in a room that you all shared. And gosh, those got outdated. And once a year, you'd get a revised edition to come, one book for the whole thing of encyclopedias, edition. And now you've got, all these search engines that allow you to go in and look at all this different input and information that you could never have found in the ways of encyclopedias. You know what I mean?
Awakening
is evolving to different ways of like, there's different styles of learning. There's different ways of getting information. There's different ways to really measure your IQ and all of that versus being, this is the only way. I like the programming I have. Yeah. If I say something's wrong with the programming I have, then I admit that my parents were wrong. I admit that my lifestyle was wrong. And people don't want to admit all of that. It's too much angst on them to admit all of that. So you're right. I mean, we're told if we're fully awakened, we'll have all of our memories and all of this. And I have bits and pieces. And I mean, I consider myself a pretty, on the move, awakening daily kind of person all my life. But to me, it's all a process. And it's we may have a lot of similarities, but it's so individual to each of us, because we all came in at different levels and waves of where we are and what our DNA resonates with.
True. I agree with you. It's the conversation that I had with someone that I love, and we will try to do an interview with, and I'm sure you will love it. It's not known on internet, just posting on Facebook, for example. I share something. I will follow. It's very interesting person and perception. And we had a discussion a couple of weeks ago, and I'm smiling because I think you will smile too. The vision that we have is so much restricted that when we start to perceive life, individual, as a human body or an interstellar body, each person is a cell. So each cell is constituted the same way. We have a mitochondria, you have a pile of Golgi and my biologist staff past. So we are all constituted the same way, but our job is different. The way we will evolve into this human body or this God body or stellar body is different. So you cannot say, I am the heart. And you're the kidney. We are different. Yes, we are different. But these are the
some people are the fecal matter. True. Some people are the fecal matter.
Yes.
Which is the dumping system, which is very important, by the way.
Yeah, that's what you said just before. We are so stuck is a little bit too strong, but I will use stuck. I will give the excuse of my French language. So we get so much stuck with some idea that is come from past, come from a program, come from the society. And then we start to say, it's not my fault, it's my parents. It's not my fault, it's my boss. It's not my fault, it's the TV. No, it's our fault. We are responsible the way we react with people within ourselves and the way we perceive life. So you had this beautiful image that come from, I think it's MIB1 or something like that, where you start to see the world, and then expanding until this planet, this galaxy, go inside the bag, and you have those two aliens, gigantic aliens, starting to play with the ball, and it's the galaxy. I love this because who knows that we are just a part of a gigantic body. So some people will say it's God, some people will say that, you know, whatever they want to say. But what if we are just a cell of this monumental body, and we have to interact with each other for understanding how this body works? Because this body doesn't know how it works. So some people will say, oh, I will use God, but I don't want to hurt anyone. But the religion said, oh, God is, you know, he will know everything. But who knows if God don't know what he's doing? Let's have a fun couple of minutes. Imagine this identity is like us, and he don't know how to behave. So we have to take any memory, any experience of those cells to try to figure it out how he works.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know. You know, we don't.
And, you know, I'm such a visual person, and I'm sitting here going through this whole like body thing as you're talking. And I'm like, okay, so we have all these components of a cell. Okay. But we have all these different cells all over the body that have to do different things in order for the body to function. Right.
Yeah.
So I was thinking of like in the brain where it's like, I want to lift my arm. So the cell in the brain's like, she's telling you to lift your arm. So the message then comes down the arm for the arm to lift, and the arm's lifting, right? And then all of a sudden the cell's like, okay, fine, I'll go down there and I'll help you rib cage. I'm going to help the rib cage. So the cell's down there helping the rib cage. And then the mind goes, I want to lift my arm. And I'm like, I can't lift my arm. Why am I not lifting my arm? Well, it's because my cell took a leave of absence to go over into my rib and help it. But the body has to function in certain ways. There's certain departments that cannot stop doing what they do, even if there's another part of the body that needs help. Somebody else will go and help them. And you have to trust that every little component, every little fiber, every little everything is operating the way it is, which is what makes all of us in this whole big universe so unique. And
yes, yes.
Why some people absolutely don't get along, and why some people are going to get along, because maybe a brain cell that moves the arm isn't going to really like the one that talks to the nerve that's in the left ankle. Mm-hmm, like, mm-hmm. Oh, you're foreign. I have no idea who you are. You are in another department. It's like having a big building where you work. A lot of people don't know each other, even in the elevator.
Exactly.
They don't know what floor you get off on and what your responsibilities are. And it's the same thing with our bodies. And what a funny concept if that was exactly how the entire world worked.
The universe and world works. I like this department, you know, not really corresponding to each other. Only the big company correspond. But when you look at people, in average people, we don't really know how to meditate. We meditate most of the time on the Western part, but not on the Eastern part. Why? Because the Eastern and Western doesn't communicate.
Yeah.
So when you start to learn about Sanskrit and all the stuff like that, you realize that we are not going on the same way. The way they see and perceive things are different than us. How the history, some civilization were perceiving things like Egypt, we don't. Some people start to connect, and we start to reconnect with the ancient wisdom, but we don't know. And we even don't know how our body works. When you said to people, you are sick because you want to be sick. People are like, no, but it's not true. I will go see a doctor. But even this guy don't know how his body works. So it is important for us to comprehend that no one will come to save us. I don't believe that. I do believe we are only the savior on our own self. When we are able to save ourselves, we can save others. So whatever, you know, we think God or Christ or Allah or the things mm-hmm. we want, it will not happen. Only us are able to change, because it's part of the free will. Every religion talks about it. But people don't want. They are staying in that.
Yeah, I think, you know, and maybe in other lifetimes, we've had to reach out of our side of ourselves a lot, right? And keep coming back and learning those lessons, all for what now? To incorporate all the me, myself, and I, all the higher selves, all the fragments of ourselves, is to call that in under one roof, because we're not leaving this physical body. Whether we did before, I don't know. Whether we are now, I don't think so. I think we are meant to really hunker into this physical temple, this physical domain, and learn how to operate every ounce of it. And that means taking the inner eye and going down through every canal, through every joint, through every part of your body, and just asking, how is this all working? And then how does it function in unison to someone else's body, right? Meaning in relationship to friends, family, coworkers, people in the store, driving in the car. How does my body react with my car, with someone else's car? And how do we keep from crashing in and hurting each other and yet become successful, happier human beings? And once you kind of tap into a lot of that, you realize how freaking amazing we are. We're freaking amazing.
We are magical. We are magical. I think that, you know, I realized a couple of days, because I, you know, with the kids, you need to meditate more.
Yes.
It's an important thing for finding your own peace, but and stabilize your own energy. But I realized a couple of days, I was watching at night, I wait that the kids sleep, but I was listening several videos at the same time. And most of the people, they said the same things, but like we said before, with their own belief or their own perception. So some people will talk about spiritism, because they talk with spirit, energy, and other stuff like that. Some others will talk with other entities from other dimensions. I was starting with at the beginning with the what was happening with the CERN and what was happening yesterday or 2 days ago with the Georgia monument that blows. And when you look at many comments, it is interesting to see the lack of knowledge that we have, but also the interest that we put on something that put us far away of who we are. The more I will put interest on, I don't know, what the world is in Ukraine, for example, the more I put myself out of who I am and the way I have to manage my own energy. So I will feed a problem that technically it's not my problem. That's what they want us to understand. And that's why I was telling you, I do believe that they oriented us to force us to change. Whatever people think it's negative, satanist, whatever the things is, we don't know. But what I feel in my guts is that they force us to change because we don't want. When you look at the gigantic perspective, we keep repeating historically the same things over and over. But now, like you were saying, the individualism, the unity, come from the work of units, and the unit is one. You cannot progress through the society, which I do believe the society will blow up totally in a couple of months, and we will shift the society because we are starting to shift it. It's done. The way we were living before, it's over. It's done. And our mental and consciousness is shifting. We cannot change that. So the war in Ukraine and Russia start to change a lot of perception. COVID was starting a lot to change perception of people. And anything, you know, you read as a comment, which is funny because it's always a duality. everyone's, yeah, it's satanic or it's good. So it's God. It is a reptilian, or I don't want to go inside, or it is Satan. We want to put other and repeating the same stuff by putting things into case, giving tag, it's bad, it's good. We did that. It's not nor good or bad. It is a change, a transition. Transition passed by chaos. The chaos is natural things to renew and reborn the new life and new things. So until we will realize that in the mass perspective, we will not change things.
Mm-hmm.
The alien can come and tell us, guys, you really need to change because now sucks.
Mm-hmm.
We will not change because many people like us have an interest and we work on ourselves. We try to change things. But if you go outside, you can see that people keep repeating the same things over and over. But they force us. And I think it's very interesting because some people will say, yeah, but what we do is a free will. It is free will. Nobody forced you to get the vaccine. Nobody forced you to go to fight in Ukraine for liberate Ukraine or whatever. We don't know. We don't know. People have theory, but it's only a theory. The fact is we need to work on ourselves. So yes. Instead of going to fight, we need to meditate and fighting in ourselves for trying to understand where is the shadow and where is the polarity of the balance.
Mm-hmm.
And we are in balance. Human is unbalanced. It is who we are.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I think as you were talking, I'm again getting visual. And there's something called a level, and it's what builders and carpenters will use. And you set it on something, and it has liquid, and it will tell you when something's level. If you want to hang a picture, whatever it is. And so what I'm seeing is like the level is it's moving. And it doesn't mean it's one is moving in a bad or a good or a better way. It just that it's shifting to see how we're tilting. We're all tilting and we're all beginning with the shift. Like, so if the majority of the people begin to shift with a, ooh, like, whoa, and then a different perception that they may not have thought of before this level started moving. And then we kind of all come back into harmony, like, oh, wow, like these big waves in a roller coaster in the ocean. You know, they all serve a purpose. And, you know, right now, I mean, to shake something up would be a little devastating for a lot of people. And yet, if we look back in history, we can see a lot of shakeups, but maybe not while it was happening. It just, we look at it because I'm a realist. That's why I like to keep it simple. Everything has to fit into my daily life and has to make sense to me on a spiritual level because spirit is who I am. I commune with the me, myself, and I of all of it every day. And I don't make decisions off of my left brain, ego, logical side. I have to tap into all my sensories. And I think it's asking us right now to open this emotional side of the body and to get into the energetics of the compassion and the loving and the understanding, not just of others, but mostly of ourselves, so that we can then recognize it and mm-hmm. share that with others and be the example for others. And it's easy for us to say, oh yeah, the little man behind the curtain and all those bad people underneath that rock, and they all did this to us, and they've kept us from this information and this technology and this, okay, fine. All right, fine. So what if they did? Now that it's opening up, can we bring some of that out behind the curtain or underneath the rock and say, okay, here, everybody, here's some light of information. Here's a different way of looking at things. And the more that you shed the light on that energetic, you know, Christ consciousness light for lack of a better expression, the more that we're exposing that darkness where things might have been hidden from our awarenesses, you know. Ooh. It's like going into the cave and reading the hieroglyphics. But before that, the cave was not exposed for us to see. Maybe only one or two people saw that. And then it was covered up and we didn't get. So now we're being able to come out and see things in different languages of energy.
I completely agree with you. And I do believe that's why now we have more truths that are revealed. You have a lot of people bringing stuff from, you know, Egypt. Michelle was telling me a couple of weeks ago, we wanted to make a video on it. And I think we will. They discover a city. They didn't discover yesterday, and discover a couple of years ago, a city named Ratanaba. And so they interact with entities. I will stop there because, you know, and the president, we love him or not, another perception, but the guy started to have an interest on it and said, we will make research on it because something's happened. So we have different people like Hancock, I don't remember exactly the name, that was developing a theory. And then after he bring facts, Joe Rogan was talking about that with him, about the city, the lost city in Brazil. So that, you know, the Amazonia was not a real forest. It was a forest created by human long time ago. So you heard people, you know, it's the lungs of, that's not true. Planet, the real lungs of the planet is the ocean, because the oxygen is made with water. So it's not only the water, it's not only the forest, it's all of us. So any beings on this planet is useful as a cell inside the body. So that's another thing. And many truths are revealed. Look, USA starting to reveal about, you know, aliens and UPAs, UAPs, they call that, not UFO anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know, like you were saying earlier, we don't know what is true, what is not, what we know, what we don't know. Once again, we need to be aware, and we are in the period that the things ask us to be aware, to remove filter. Doesn't mean that you have to absorb every single thing that you heard, because if not, you will become crazy. But in a general sense, when you listen to people, channeler, you have people reading card, people reading in crystal, the wizards, they exist since thousand, if it's not million years, because I do believe in a couple of months we will realize that human nature is not what we heard about history. It's way more than that. But a lot of people will resist on it. Why? Because we still have this duality. And like you said, this time, it is for removing duality. We will dissolve it for making unity. And that's why it is asking to work on ourselves, which is the unit. COVID, if we reverse it, I think we said that the first video, COVID is difficult, division of collective, divide the collective. They try to divide us. But the reality, if we see it with another perception, doesn't mean we are right. But it created the good things. People are stronger, vaccine, not vaccine, whatever it is.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We become stronger. We're starting to have more community. At the beginning was destroying us, but now we stop. We start to see people going in the street saying, no, it's over. We stop the stupidity. We heard that Pfizer starting to have a problem with the justice court in the US.
Mm-hmm.
So we have revelation. We have our friend, I call him the alien, Elon Musk, that now wants to travel to Mars. Well, the question that we need to ask is why the guys want to go to Mars? Why? What is the purpose? We have so much things to do on Earth. Maybe he wants to go there for finding facts. Who knows? We don't know. So that's why I totally agree with you. We are actually removing a lot of things, a lot of program for us to absorb information and reveal the information that is within our DNA. and this, the Egyptians talk about it. The ancient civilization talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
But we're still not understanding because our society teach you stuff that it's not helping. Other than saying, I refuse it. Now we'll work on what I do believe, like you said, what I feel resonate within me to progress and step forward into this illumination or raising consciousness. And it is very important to do that. But it's amazing the quantity of information that we have now through YouTube, through other stuff, that can help us to find what is resonating within us and then helping us to go forward.
Yeah, and you know, being able to listen to all the information and allow it to filter without grabbing a hold of it and saying, oh, I believe in this one, therefore I don't believe in this philosophy, or I believe in this facts and I don't believe in the way this person's doing the facts. It's like, we don't know what the facts are. We're going through fossils of information, fossils, literally fossils of information, and things that in languages that were never written, you know, and things like that too. So human nature is, when you hear something that doesn't sound familiar, you shut it down and resist it. And some people will have a visceral freaking response at times to certain things. And I said a couple years ago, one of the biggest things that's going to occur over the next 3 to 5 years, I think I said this around 2018, is people are not going to know who to trust, because everybody wants to get out there and say, oh no, this is the way it is. Well, hey, can't we just all throw it out there and put it together like this beautiful quilt of information until more information comes, and then we can expand on the quilt. But each little patch represents new ways of having information. And so we ourselves learn to just shut all of that off when it comes to something new, instead of, so when I don't listen to the news, I haven't since the 90s, I was told not to. It's just very hard on my system. And I live more in the now moment anyway. So things that are just of negativity is like, why did I just take my time to fill my cell with that information? What did it do for me? It just made me feel like the world's a horrible place, because that was their perception long before any of this other stuff. So more and more information is going to surface as we do these archaeology digs. And, you know, then we have to be careful of, you know, who's funding those digs, because it's whoever is funding these digs are going to dictate when and how that information is going to come out, because they have to profit on all of it. But what we have now is we have all these, what I would call myself, and I don't know what your background is, but a layman. I'm a total layman, but I'm looking for my own archaeological digs of information that come through me directly from spirit. And then next thing I know, I'm around people that have something to say about something I just thought about this morning, and I don't even know these people. And then you get together and our cells just come alive with the possibilities of creating a story of maybe something. But it's all stories. It's all information. It's all lessons. It's all the level on the wall trying to balance the picture, you know?
And that's why I communicate with a person that is from Scotland. And by the way, I love their accent better than mine. She was sending me today information about the Bible. I'm not, like we discussed the first time, I'm not quite crazy about religion.
It's okay. You could express that. This is your way of expressing how your cells feel about that.
Exactly. But I use it for understanding what is the metaphoric message that is beyond. And she was sending me some things that the page, remember the title, I will put when we will make the montage. It's about what is going on right now. the way we behave and the way we behave the society, because the society doesn't put anything in our head, doesn't teach us anything. It's because of us, the society, the general consciousness, go on one way. So like you said, and I absolutely agree, it's not one explanation, one fact, is several facts, but we don't know if it's real fact or not, because again, we don't know who is behind the founds, what we, some people found, make funds for some injection, and now we are realizing that make damage.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, it's exactly the same things of our body and the universal body, the cells. We need to understand what kind of cell bring as a work, what is the work that they, the duty that they have, and associate each like a puzzle. We are a puzzle. We know about anything. So you have specialists that they will start to explain you stuff, and you're like, but man, in 5 years, 2 years, or even a couple of months, the version of your story will change dramatically, because we are in the period where stuff start to pop up, and we have more and more people able to channel in a certain amount of, you know, information. But it's a fact. You have people that are able to absorb information, even us. So what is crazy is that, like you said, sometimes an information comes and we resist on it. Instead, just speaking what is resonating within us. And then we realize that this information will be repeated by people that we will cross outside a conversation, or even some things that we read. Like yesterday, when the things blow in Georgia, I make a comment saying, I have a military background. So I medical, but military. And I said to the guys, for me, it could be a rocket from a drone, but we will see a smoke or at least a flash. I do believe that it's a C4, so the explosive. The way it blasts, the way it blow, and the smoke and stuff like that. So the guys tell me, no, but, you know, I know it's the accurate shooting. I'm like, okay, but I don't explain my past. And I keep it for me. And it is the way we are so much certain of what we said, or the information what we give, or our perception. And sometimes you are like, you look at the comment or the perception or even the idea that you have in your head, and you want to say something. My grandpa used to say, turn your tongue 7 times in your mouth, and when you are done, repeat it. Like that, you will be make sure that the information that you will release will be the one that resonates within.
So wow.
I try to do that. So 7 times, and then you're like, I will keep going on because I'm
just
not
Michelle
sure.
Michelle ever go, answer me. And you go, I'm on roll number 4. I'll be with you in a minute.
Just a couple of minutes. Can you have water? So no, we have a very huge amount, especially since the last year, a huge amount of ancient wisdom. You have, you know, this guy releasing, you probably heard about the guy talking about the CERN, but he talked about the guardian of the looking glass. I'm not a fan of it for many reasons, but what he explained is interesting. What he dig into it is interesting. The proportion of information, for me, I block it. I stop, because if not, it's too much and you it's like a beep. But some information that he gives, especially about ourselves and how the things can go, is not necessarily what resonating, but what can help me to search on another way and say, oh, wow, that's interesting. And like you said, it can resonate. And then suddenly it unlocked some things and you're like, whoa. And then the channel start to go on and on. And you're like, whoa, it's not only Netflix, it's Amazon. It's a lot of channel. So I mean, the only civilization that was, to me, the most accurate in terms of the way of living was the native. You know, the native in Australia, the native in New Zealand, the native in America. Because the way they were interacting with each other, with the nature, even when they were killing an animal, it was a ritual. Now you will eat, you will consume, you will overconsume without any gratefulness, if I may say. Just eat the thing. Let's go to McDonald's. It's good. And we consume our life the same way. So people develop cancer, develop stuff. And when you ask them, what is the biggest mistake in your life? They keep saying, oh, it's not living the life. But what if the biggest mistake is just looking at ourselves, because all the information, like you said, about the encyclopedia, we are the encyclopedia. We don't need to dig in any things. The more I dig in my study, the more I realize that I'm like, but the knowledge is so logical. How I can be so dumb? Because the information that it's released and contained into our cells, we have billion cells, like the planet. We have billions of life. To me, we should look at the life for trying to understand that everything is connected. The same way we have to perceive our body, meaning it's not one entity, but it's a multiple organism works together.
Mm.
And those, when they are all unified, you are God. Nothing can reach you. And you have so much power. You see the electricity between two atoms, like you said in English, how the cell is able to multiply, it's just crazy. Like the kids had the gastroenteritis, they were crushed. 24 hours after, whoa, daddy, let's go play to the beach. And you're like, no, I want to sleep. Because the human nature is definitely a God. We are incarnated into this physical body, a divinity. We are God. We have so much power, but we don't see it. Like, no, I don't want to see it.
We don't see it. And unfortunately, we've had medical schools created that just have boxes of Band-Aids in the form of prescription pads, and I'm not faulting it, because some of those things are very life-saving and wonderful. So that's another prime example of East meeting West. It just, one cannot dominate. You have to have the level out, and it must be level for each situation, right? And I think we've gotten away from the grassroots of our, just our own basic history of our parents and our grandparents and the grandparents before them. Much less 200 years before that, 400 years before that, 5,000 years. And I don't give a crap how old the earth is. I don't care who says, oh, this was like 5 million, or this was, oh, it was only, no, I'm sorry, it was 4,332. Oh, no, it was 400, 100 million, 30. I'm like, I don't care. I don't care. And I don't know where I was in the universe on those levels. But what I know is I'm here now. And what's the best I can do in this moment for the now? And, you know, I question sometimes, every time I think I'm making some leaps forward of understanding, something will come along and go, I don't know crap.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't know crap. And then I'm like, okay, so obviously there's more voids up in here than I realized. And not everything needs to be filled. I could float around the voids. It feels pretty freaking good sometimes just to float up there in the nothingness. I remember when I was married once, my ex would say, what are you thinking? I go, I don't know. I completely forgot what I was thinking. How do you do that? I go, I don't know. I just do. I'm just like, and then in the last couple of years, it's gotten worse and worse. And I don't even look at it as worse. I look at it as, obviously, I've made room for some new stuff. That's how I'm looking at it. I'm cleaning out my mental, physical, spiritual, there are layers and levels and closets And I think so many of us are out here thirsty for new information that we're almost so thirsty that we actually believe, you know, everything. The buckets of the brown stuff, you know what I'm saying? And no, it's like, true. Then you look back and you go, wow, how the heck did I fall for that snake venom salesperson? But we do. Well, no, anyway, that's true. Some people do.
No, that's true. That's true. But I like the fact that you use the level, because if we take, again, the Christianity, the Christ was a carpenter. So, you know, people, so if he talk about our money, and if he was a carpenter, automatically he find the balance.
Yeah.
He create the harmony. And that's why I use the term temple, because the temple needs to be stabilized and with a great foundation. But when you really read behind the metaphor, you understand that. And everything is explained. So I sometimes I'm laughing because you said something that I recognize myself. You start to erase ancient or previous information. You're like, oh, that's... bullshit. Let's take a new thing. And you have a case that they are empty. And you are like, I'm not thinking. I'm not reflecting about anything.
I think so many people want so much of this to come back to the roots of a Bible. And I don't think it ever will. I'll tell you why I don't think it ever will. It's because it was that the Bible was created and recreated and constructed and reconstructed and destructed and resurrected and then inserted and excerpted and literally torn up and burned and then rewritten. And so it's always going to be there to confuse people. It's not a factual historical events, as far as I'm concerned. I grew up in religion. I never understood it. I had to kind of quietly go along with it until I was old enough to be out on my own. And I don't argue with people who have that belief system, as long as that makes them a happy person and they are happy based on the happiness part of the essence of it. But if, you know, you've got people out here now just using it to be another tool of information. You've got people out here now trying to get you into this conspiracy things of all these other things. And then saying, after they get all these following, they'll say, and then you'll be saved if you claim the Lord Jesus Christ is your Lord. And you're like, that's an occult. To me, that's an occult. It's my way, no it's way. It's through Jesus and only Jesus. That's bull crap. I've had conversations with the essence of that man since I was a child. And I've gotten angry a few times because I keep telling him, can you just tell people the truth? And he's told me it's coming. It's coming. It's coming. It's coming. And so he's just said, mind your business, Sandy, and do what you need to do in other ways. It's not your fight. And so I've stayed out of it. But we're talking about pathways of information. But people are just still, because there's a lot of people that have many spiritual belief systems that have absolutely freaking nothing to do with the BIBLE, nothing to do with it. And so, you know, I don't know about a lot of other religions. And if another religion was saying I had to do it their way and not my way, I would say, wow, you're taking away my free will and choice by saying your savior is better than my savior. What? You know, and so that is where I have always said the biggest part of separation and discrimination and victimism and suffering and control has been from that particular book. That particular book. It has, you know, man taking life from each other, if you don't believe in it. And so if we can look at that as just a pathway of information that possibly could help you be exactly. But let's also look at some other pathways. And that is really where we are. And you and I were talking about this before we hit record. There's so many different pathways to the puzzle. There's so many different pieces of fabric for the quilt. There's so many different paint choices for different rooms. And there's so many different aesthetics to choose for the buildings and the landscaping and so much. Find the beauty in all of it. And the more you allow that, the more your actual physical bodies, the cells move, and the more they move and they glide, and then they start eradicating the cells that are not functioning properly, and they're making room for new information and new cells. That is what I think you and I are saying today, be open to this. But if I got up every day trying to figure out a quest for certain things, I would fill this void with so much nonsense that I wouldn't know what was left, right, up, down, true, false, good, bad, different. I'm just saying, those are labels for me. But as we talked about, we just need to filter all the information on how it feels and how it resonates with us, because I might only be in first grade. You might be in fifth grade, you know what I mean? Of all these different levels. And it doesn't mean the higher up you go, the better it is. It just means maybe you're supposed to resonate here for a while, and you need to spin out over here for a little bit.
It's another interesting thing. That's why I like we have a conversation. Because I'm part of a group, kind of Freemason. We don't kill our kids. Where we need to pass certain grade, like at school. So the lodge that I am in is more about magical stuff. So it is interesting because the first grade, they teach you how to cleanse your aura. You know, understanding the sphere of feeling, of sensation, or by the word that I use, they will recognize it. And this is very important for the first 9 to 12 months. But then after you pass to another level, doesn't mean that you are better than the first guys that come and start to do these things and ritual for cleaning himself. No, it's just that the first part is cleansing your auric sphere. Then so you cleanse you and yourself, and then you pass on elemental stuff. So you start to work with energy and elemental. It's exactly what you said. It's not because one person is on grade one and the second one is on grade five that the grade five knows more. It's just that the experience is different, because this life, where we are right now, we need to stay into it for progressing. If you can progress until the eighth grade for this life, super cool. If you stay in the first grade and you still be happy, mega cool. But like you said, we still running about some things. We run about, I would not say we run about knowledge, because when we talk to most people, you start to see that the knowledge that they have, or they think, or we think we have, is good for today, but not good for tomorrow. It will change, it will switch. And that's why we need to stay open. And like you said, once again, religion are not a dogmatic things. I mean, they use as a dogmatic. It's should not be a cult, like Freemason or you know, Rosicrucian or stuff like that. They are not cult. If they become cult, they become dangerous. And I invite people to leave by running away. We should use secret society, which are not secret because everyone knows it. It's just the knowledge that they are transferring, which we call esoterical, they cannot provide to everyone. Because if they provide to everyone, you will still have some asshole that they will try to get it for their own power. And if you take, for example, Rosicrucian or some Freemason, not all, they try to do good, but in secret, meaning they try to be silent to try to do good for people. Not all do that. It's not what I said, but I said that we cannot release all the information. And even when we are into it, you cannot get, sorry, I have some noise.
Yeah, it's fine.
My lion.
It's fine.
The house. And this, for me, it's very important because it's joining what we were saying. We have so much preconcept of what is good, what is bad, due to the fact of the religion, because nothing else was before. our society, we become degenerated, like completely degenerated, retarded, I would say. No, this is bad. I'm just eating the candy and it's making me happy.
Yeah.
No, it's bad because of sugar. It's not bad because of sugar.
It's all on your mental thought with it.
Exactly. Some people eat sugar and they are perfectly fine without any insulin problem, obesity problem, because we never know. Well, don't drink Coca-Cola every day for sure. But it's the way you enjoy life, the way you enjoy yourself, the way you know yourself that will completely change another one passing. So now the family will. We definitely live an interesting, because it's shaking the tree to change us, to complete. It didn't fall. Oh yeah, the computer. Ah yeah, that's not that good.
Well, I agree with you 100%. And you know, when you were talking, I was seeing a building being built. And it's like the first brick isn't more important than the last brick. And then it brought me to, it's the foundation. Your foundation building is what you're doing here. We're foundation building, right? We're getting back to the roots of the foundation. What happens when the building falls? The foundation is always still there.
Mm-hmm.
And the higher a building goes, the stronger the foundation, and then you have to have this sway and this movement for ground movement, for air movement, for everything else. So all these levels that we get to, one does not mean better than the other, but it's like each brick must be laid properly, just like each level must be taken seriously and properly, because each one builds off of the next.
Ooh.
If you get sloppy after a couple layers and halfway do this one, and, you know, then the whole thing's going to fall down, you know? Nobody wants that crap, but it happens. But we're building foundations. But the thing is, we're building new foundations off of some history and then some new history that's coming in, that maybe a pathway that none of us would ever have thought of. So before we shut that down and get into this visceral response, no. My way is the only way. Your way isn't. Then we've shut off our pathway for inner growth and for creating new foundations, and we pass that on to our little children's.
Yes.
Like don't open the door to that. Don't open your taste buds to that. We encourage our children to try things, but they actually look at our actions, not our words. Are you trying it? Are you doing it? Are you loving life? You know?
Exactly. We are the It's the conversation that I had with my ex-wife yesterday. We were talking about the kids and the way we educate them and we parent them, parenting. And I says, since long time, we are not parents. We are not here for educate our kids. We are here for guiding them, because they look at what we are doing. They don't give a crap about what we are saying, because they are not listening. They hear, but it's passed through.
Yeah, they'll do as you do.
Show them. What we show them, make them. I have three sons, one daughter, two sons. They are crazy about stone. If you see around my computer, I'm full of amethyst, other stone. I have tons of stone, because I show them that I'm a wild guy, obviously. So I like to be in nature. I like, you know, I have cactus, I have plants. How we show we live our life is the way our kids will follow, continue to construct this building, because we are only the foundation for them, as our grandparents were the foundation for our parents. And boop, 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 the layers go up.
Yeah.
And that's why some people said, oh, we are the new generation, cleanse the karma of the family. You know, if you look at the Eastern way of seeing the spiritual and philosophy. But it is simply because we build our own house, our temple, but we build the temple of our family, and we build the temple of the human family. And that's why our structure actually is shaky, shaky, baby, like say the guys on internet. But the reality is, like you said, once again, I agree, the foundation that we have will stay because it's always stay there. It's who we are and how we connect with each other. We don't know each other, but we connect. You don't know another person, but you connect with other people. Because this is the foundation of humanity, we are not able to live on ourselves in the freaking forest. And people will say, no, I will be happy. I will be the first to say that. But man, you live with tree, you live with animals, you live with the lake, you live with the mountain, whatever. You have to interact with the nature and your environment because it's teaching you who you are. So I think in a couple of months, or it will be funny, I mean, for us, to be funny to observe how the things will go and see how some people react compared to the knowledge that we will receive. It will be a fantastic and humoristic way of living the next probably 2-3 years. I don't think we will go more than 5 years. After 5 years, the society will completely shift.
And we're shifting by the boatloads now without even realizing that it's happening. I'm so in tune with what's been going on with me. And I mean, I don't, I never have to hear about a CME or a solar flare or a Schumann's. That stuff's been going on since the beginning of time. Yes. We just happen to have something that can read it and get it out there. Okay. And by the way, who even knows if that's correct? My body tells me every time there's a shift. My body will tell me and I will say, okay, I'm listening. What's happening? I'm listening to what's going on. It's that inner barometer.
Yes.
That inner barometer, that compass that's awakening. True. And that's a gut inner intuitiveness. I live by it every day, but when stuff is going on, it's so acute to me. That it's like, okay, stop, drop, sit. Let me just feel with that. Or I mosey on about my day and I just make a note. I'm aware of that. I felt that. I sensed that. I got that. And I just ask them to continue to build on it because every moment that I pay attention, I'm building on the next moment of paying attention.
Cool.
And I'm building on the next moment of paying attention. And so this whole momentum. There's no rush to it because the more I marinate in those moments, the more information I get. Sometimes it might be freaking aches and pains or things bobbing around in my head, you know, like I need to get busy. This is ridiculous kind of thing. It's kind of like trying to sit down and meditate and you're like, ow, I can't cross my legs. Oh, my back hurts. Or what was that thought? Or, oh shoot, I forgot to go make that note about that. And then next thing you know, you're 20 minutes of up down. You're like, oh, I guess it's not time for me to meditate right now. and I just laugh at myself. But I'm so excited to see the next steps of information and the next steps of information. And I can't encourage people enough to find lightweight programs like this.
Yes,
that there isn't anyone pushing an agenda. It's all the only thing that we're saying is tap into yourself a little bit more. Ask yourself, what does that information do for me? Is it really important right now? How does my body feel when I listen to it? And then my body is my body, but like you, I don't have to go around my wife and my children and this people. How, am I bringing their energy down? Are their cells going, oh God, like, you know what I mean? Or is it like an uplifting of like, you know, it's so lightweight. I like this. It's happy. So we have to be respectful of how what we're taking in and how others might react to that as well.
Yes.
Because that's called do no harm. You know, absolutely. We do harm when we overload ourselves.
No, absolutely. The way we react, I mean, I've seen that when, you know, it's been 2 years that I was out of my kids because of Brazil, because of the situation, because of many, many factors. So my ex-wife decided, because the kids were asking, and I think she needed vacation too, to bring the kids to me, because the way I live my life is different. So the first 2 weeks that they were here, I was observing a lot myself, blowing up. I was nearly a volcano, because I was between, you know, I will not call that spirituality. I will probably call more awareness of being observing what's going on in myself and how I was interacting with those two little beings that part of me.
Mm.
And since a couple of days, especially when they started to be sick, I started to observe them differently. So go back on my ritual meditation, because I was forgetting myself. I was putting 100%, 1000% on them. But it's not helping me. It's not helping them, because the way I was interacting with them, being like tense and, you know, trying to figure it out, those 2 years, how to manage it. And then suddenly I'm like, no, release it. Because if I'm not able to enjoy, to observe them, I can only drag them down and not having a great time with them and not showing them the way I live my life.
Mm-hmm.
So we decided, for example, today, we did a lot of stuff, and I decided to take them to walk. And one of them, the one that had little issues, started to tell me, hey, Dad, can you carry me? The guy is very heavy. So I took him, his dance. And he started to tap on my head and said, Dad, what if we live in the big house and we come to live with you? What, you know, the question was like, what will happen? And I said, nothing. Because you need, if the universe give you a mom one side, a dad one side, it's the question is not about love. The question is you to be able to observe how both people work,
mm-hmm.
how both people work on themselves, how we behave with the nature, with our environment, and finding the harmony. Try to pick the best of each. Daddy is not the best. Mommy is not the best. We try our best. But you are the best, because you will be able to mix those two freaking idiot entities and going forward to try to figure out the balance. And I said, you know, that is not a real dad, he's your guide. I'm not here for telling you what to do. I'm here for telling you, watch out. If you go on this way, you will have a consequence. If you go on this way, you will have a consequence. And his response on the conversation was like, but what is bad and what is wrong? Or what is good? I said, nothing. It just depends on how you feel and how you interact with people. Is it good to insult people? For some people, it's the mm-hmm. way they've been raised. To me, my education and with the way of military, we have to respect people. Good morning, sir. Good morning, madam, ma'am. And thank you for holding the door. This is my way. This is not necessarily the best way to live. So feel free to observe how people interact with you, because the way they interact with you and the way you interact with them will give you the man that you are. When I said man, it's the human nature. And the answer of the little one, which is a fireball of energy, is full of energy. He said, so technically we are free of everything. I'm like, yeah, but why I cannot fly? And I said, you can fly, but not like a bird, but you can fly.
Mm-hmm.
So
good point.
Like you said, the way you transmit the information is not by word, is trying to give them metaphoric and especially action. They need to see you happy. And the fact that they will see us parents happy, their roots will become so strong, so strong. And this is a problem in our society. Kids don't have roots anymore. Hey, take the phone. Take the phone, you make too much noise.
Yeah, take the remote, take the computer, take this, take that. You know, we're guardians of their souls, and we chose to do that before they came through. And regardless of how our guardian took care of us, we have the opportunity to erase that board and see the sacredness in being a guardian of these souls. But then we also have to help them on all the other human levels, how to navigate as a human. And there's no better way to navigate as a human than to know the barometer of how you feel. Okay, sure. I ate too much candy. What's too much candy? How my stomach felt. I got a headache. Okay, just recognize how that felt.
Yes.
And then next time, you know where and when your stopping point is, right? You run too fast without your shoelaces tied. You know, you trip, you fall. Okay, what's your lesson? Maybe run a little slower and make sure I tie my shoes. So, you know, these are just lessons that we're helping to teach them. And I think that's what makes aware parents and grandparents so freaking awesome.
Yes.
I love kids and I do a great job with kids and I work with kids. And sometimes I think I do a great job because I can be detached and they have to go home with their parents. But I do want to make sure that they, their parents get a nugget of something that sees their children differently and their children see their parent differently so that I can feel like I'm helping with the whole world being in a better community, one being at a time or one group at a time. Well, I'm so sorry your better half didn't get an opportunity to join us, and we will definitely do this again. Is there any other, I mean, I know you've got a website and I'll have everything listed below, but is there anything that you would like to share with our viewers today before we commence?
I mean, it's always first. It's always a pleasure to discuss with you. I mean, the only thing that I keep repeating even in our video is, I mean, it's what we try to give. Nothing is good or bad. Nothing is, like we said, oh, this is true, this is not. It's only about belief. And the belief is nothing else than the program that we have installed in ourselves. When we are able to recognize that, like you said, with the kids, when we are able to detach ourselves of any attachment, and we put back love where it should be, what love is, which is detachment and observing people as they are and with their good and bad and accepting them in their entire cells or energy field, then we are able to be more aware and open to receive and transmit to others the real cleanse energy, pure energy of love. And this is what we try to, and even in your video, I recognize that too, how people can be so much out of the own jail that we have our own key and we are, nope, I want to keep it because I want to be a victim today. Just love. Love is freedom. And when we recognize that, I see that a couple of days ago, I confirm it, that releasing the tension, releasing any disturbance that we have in our mind to observe only what is now, the life is so much better. The life is so much beautiful. So, and I think this is the sparks of what people call God. I love to call that dog, because dog is the best friend of the human. And whatever you will do to him, I have my dog like licking my feet right now because I hurt myself, and he's licking the blood for healing because for him it's instinctive.
Yes.
We lost this. We lost this connection. The dogs, you know, needs to wait. I will walk him when I want. No. You need to pay attention on him because it's now the connection that you have with this animal that loves you unconditionally. You need to transmit to him the same things and same things for the other people.
Yes. I love what you're saying about pets. You know, dogs are guardians of the humans and cats are guardians of the spirituality. And, you know, my kids are grown. The pets have already passed over. It's been a while. And they come to me in my dreams and I do shed tears and things like that. And recently I've had other pets coming to me in my dreams. And then recently I've gone to people's homes where they have had taken in, say, a rescue dog that has very bad manners, and telepathically we communicate. And so for the past few weeks, I've got people calling me going, I've rescued some animals. I heard you're really good. Can you come over? And I start my work before I get there. And it's been very interesting because I could be having a conversation like with you, but I'm working on this animal over here. And I'm great unexpected, no expectations, because it's just a telepathic communication between, and some dogs have a different thread with me and some cats may have a different thread with me. So some will resonate. They can look right at me and they know exactly what we're talking about, but I don't dominate. I let it be their choice. Information comes in, we communicate, and their behavior changes.
Yeah.
And one day I'll have them physically again where I can snuggle up with them. I love animals and children. Sure. And I love my private time too. Just gonna say that. Sorry.
I agree.
Everybody, this is we could chit chat for hours.
Yes.
So thank you for joining us. I want you to go to YouTube and I want you to look up Awakening Tribes. I want you to subscribe, to like, to share. We don't do this for everyone to like us because everyone's got different things. But the machine that says your video gets circulated, it requires a like. It requires a comment. It requires something that tells the machine, oh, move it. So that the videos don't get stuck in the dungeon, so to speak.
Yes.
So please, you know, join Samuel and Michelle's channel. He's got great stuff that he comes out with, and you love his accent too, and now y'all do. and then, of course, do the same thing for this video and for my channel. And we'll see you on the next video. So much love to each and every one of you. Samuel, thank you for joining us. And next time we'll have the little woman on the show again too. All right. Bye, everybody.
She's taking the lion right now.
Yes. All right.
Bye.
Bye.